Hello friends, welcome to the Smart XLO. I hope you all good, and I have come with a new video of counting the number of colors in cells colors on based on the value or the sum. So it's very useful for the milestones calculations, and also I will be doing a couple of doing a group of videos on this. So approximately it will be 4 to 5 based on the capacity and velocity. So now let's start with this. So here is the database, and you can see that if I increase or decrease any number, how this color range gets affected. So if I do this to 6, so let me just scroll a bit. So if I make this into 0, so you can see how the things are getting affected, how the color values are getting affected. So I'll be showing you what formula to be used in this, and apart from that, I'll be showing you what we can do in calculating milestones. And this is just a synopsis or just a brief about what I'm going to show you. So if I want to have a milestone, if I want to have a calculation stone, so this I'm going to cover in a separate video. So it will be showing you expired or the day is left, or it's showing you, so it's all for 2019. So whenever I have to select something, and I see, you can see it's in March. So if I want to have something, this is for April, this is for March, so it's selecting in this area. So if I want to make this, if I make this into an April, so if I make this into a Jan, so we can see the things will be changed over here. So if I make this into 1, and if I do this, so you can see the thing. So this pink color is the mid of the month. So this is scheduled for milestones, and you can see automatically how it affects, and you can have a brief about it. It's like for Microsoft projects, we use this sort of formulas, and if you control Z, you can see it's a March, it goes the way you want. So it's a very big lengthy one. So it is going to help you better. You can see here. So this is the dates over here. So whenever you select a date, if I make this into 1st of Jan, and you can see how it gets affected. So you can see the values get changed. So apart from this, if I make this scroll down and I come to a small extent, I can see that I have this till October and December. So I have made a format. So when I click this, when I click 1, so you can see 6 months is hidden over here. So you can see July, August, and all. So if I click 2 again, you can see that you can see till June. So anyhow, this is a separate video I'll be making on how to make ifs and how to get a formula for this. And apart from that, same I have done for June to December. So this is only for June to December. This is for the whole year. This is June to December. So it should be July to December, it's not June, I think. So it's July to December. And apart from here, this is also a milestone. You can see the data sets getting changed. You know, if I convert this into somewhere around here, if I make this into 2019, so you can see how it gets changed over here. So if I do Control Z, the things get changed. So this is also a milestone. This is for the years, and I'm going to do for quarters also. And this is also a milestone. In a separate video, I'm going to do all those things. And this is for the cell colors. Now I'm going to show you how to do this one for the cell colors. So if you want to see the number of cells to be calculated, so I already made a format over here. So let me show you. So this is maximum I can have many number, but I have restricted it to 14, so you can have unlimited numbers. So what you have to do is, in the beginning, you have to write a formula for this. It's a formula, so it's going to be like if, and if you open the parenthesis, so you can see E3. So this should be greater than or equal to this one. If it is greater than or equal to, then the answer should be 1, else it should be none. And if you close this, you can see it's going to show you 1. But I want to scroll it down and up and down, so I will be making a cell reference. So this is going to make, I'm going to make this into a, for the column. So I'll be clicking F4, 1, 2, and 3. So if you see the dollar mark over here, it's going for the column wise. And for here, if I want to pull this down, I want to go in this way. So I'm going to even place F4, 1, 2, so 2 times, and I'm going to hit enter. So you can see this is 1 and whatever is till 7. So you can see that till 7 it's calculating 1. Then if I move forward, it's not calculating any number. So I'm having this. So for the better view, what I will be doing is I'll be pulling this down and I'll be making this till whatever array you have. So you can see if this calculations is equal, then you can see that you'll be getting an answer 1. But I don't want this 1 to be vision. I want something to be colored in this. So what I can do is I'm going to select this whole area and the whole which is to my database. And if you want, you can select, see this, select this whole area and go to conditional formatting. And in conditional formatting, make a new rule. And in new rule, you can say cells, format only cells that contain. So here we can give a format and formula. You can see cells that, cells value, and you can make here between, you can make it to equal to. So I'm, you can see that the whole value which we have given a formula is giving 1. You can give any value. If it is 1, let's make it 1. So whatever value is 1, we can change the format color. So I'm going to give a fancy color like this. I hope it's the right color. Or you can select from here the area, or you can select the visor one. So it's on second one. And I'm going to do is OK. And I'm going to do is OK. So you can see that. Yeah, but again, you can see the colors in 1 and it's visible. So if you want that to be invisible, you can just select this and you can, I think it's this one. Yeah, so you can see whenever I select the right things, it keeps on changing. So I think this is the right one. So we had selected this aqua accent 60%. So now we got this thing on the board. So now this formula is so adoring that if you do any changes, it's going to affect you simultaneously. If I make this 2 and I hit enter, so you can see it comes till here. So this is a way you can do this, and it's a very simple formula. But apart from this, I'm going to make some complex formula in the next one. So I'm going to show you for the milestones, so that if you hit any data, how it is going to change simultaneously. And this one, this formula, I'm going to show you in a separate video. So that is, this is going to help us a lot, you know, when we have some programs, some project completion. So I hope you understand this video, and if I like this video useful, and I would like to ask you to subscribe to my channel, and please share and like this video and give me your comments. So hope to see you in the next video in the milestones. And thanks for watching.